the Snapdragon 875 chipset is codenamed Lahaina and can be significantly faster than expected. An initial benchmark shows a score of more than 847,000 points in AnTuTu, which currently tops the charts with 663,000 points or more. That's a jump of more than 25%, a big jump for an annual update. Of course, these results will need to be corroborated. In comparison, the iPhone 12 scored 660,000 points, while the Kirin 9000 and Exynos 1080 achieved scores of 696,000 points and 693,000 points respectively, enough to beat the current Snapdragon 865 phones, but far from the supposed result of the Snapdragon 875. Interestingly, the AnTuTu charts are currently led by the Snapdragon 865. The AnTuTu team explains that the RAM and storage configurations also play a role in the final score. So the high capacity UFS 3.1 storage might offset the minor clock speed deficit of the non-plus chipset. Another post mentions that Oppo is testing an overclocked version of the 865, which will reach 3.2 GHz or more. The main core of the Snapdragon 865 Plus has a frequency of 3.09 GHz. Qualcomm will officially present the Snapdragon 875 and other chips on 1st of December. And if this benchmark result is to be believed, the event will be a must-see. Now let's talk about the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 with S Pen. Rumors about the launch of Samsung's next folding device keep coming. And now a new patent registration raises expectations that the next Galaxy Z Fold 3 may come with an integrated S Pen. We have already seen that Samsung should use a thicker screen to allow a stylus to be used in the foldable by users without serious problems. And although about the possible use of under-display selfie camera on the device has not gained more evidence, it seems that Samsung should bet its chip on the S Pen. In the patent discovered by Let's Go Digital, we see that the S Pen could be placed in the corner of the device, possibly in the lower right region, the same position where the Galaxy Note lineup adopted the exit of its S Pen until the launch of the new Note 20 and Note 20 Ultra. So far, we know that Samsung must replace the electromagnetic resonance solution adopted in the Note lineup to use a new layer of active electrostatic solution in the Z Fold 3, since the EMR is rigid and cannot be folded. With S Pen being used on top of the plastic panel, Samsung is expected to present some technology that improves the resistance of the next folding display. As the current screen of the Z Fold 2 is still very susceptible to damage and scratches, the Galaxy Z Fold 3 should be presented in mid-2021, probably in August, alongside the Galaxy Note 21. For now, all the information is nothing but rumors. And despite the evidence being reinforced each week, it can be changed until the official launch. If you like this video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. And if you want to support me on Patreon, the link is given in the description. And I will see you guys in the next one. Until then, bye-bye.